If you are building an app with Bubble, you probably already came across annoying scroll bars that you want to get rid of. Well, if it's the case, you're watching the right video, because in this one, we're going to take a look at how you can get rid of those scroll bars in just a few minutes in Bubble. If you don't know me, my name is Thomas, I've been a Bubble developer for almost 3 years now, and I'm the founder of NoCodable Components, a UI kit made for Bubble. On this channel, you will find a lot of tips that will help you build better Bubble applications, so make sure to subscribe. Alright, let's get going. So, the first thing I'm going to need is an element for which I want to add the scroll bars. In this case, I'm going to use a table element that I'm copying from NoCodable Components, but it will work with any element, which is group, repeating groups, whatever element in Bubble. So, in this case, I'm just going to give it some max height to make sure that we easily see our scroll bar. And if I hit preview, and now we can see that, I have my scroll bar here, and I can see that it can be annoying in some cases. Alright, so the first step you're going to need to do is to go into your app setting, into the general tab, and at the very bottom of the page, you will see an option called expose the option to add an ID attribute to HTML element. Make sure that this checkbox is checked, it is very important. Now that this option is activated, when we go to your table element, or your repeating group, or your group, you can see that you have a new input at the bottom of the property panel. The input is called ID attribute, and it is very important because it will enable us to give an HTML attribute to this element so that we can target it with some code. So go ahead and give an attribute to this element. In this case, I'm going to give it the name of no scroll bar, but you can choose whatever ID you want. Now that you've done that, we are going to need to add a little bit of custom code to our app. By default, YouTube does not allow me to paste some HTML code into the description, so I'm going to give you the link in the description to go to this article on NoCodable Components, within which you are going to find the necessary code to add to your app. Alright, so now we need to copy this code and add it to our application. So go ahead, copy this code, and go back to your application. We are going to add this code on the page level of our app. So here you can select your page, which is in my case named Height Scroll Bars. And then in the page HTML header, you are going to paste the code. Now be careful, you need to make sure that the ID in our code, which is just here, and the ID in our element are exactly the same. For example, in my case, the ID of my table is slightly different from the one in my page. So I'm going to go ahead, copy the one here and add it to my table so that I'm sure that it is exactly the same. All right, so now let's hit preview and see what our element looks like. As we can see, I can scroll inside it and I don't see any scroll bar here, so our code did work. Now, there is an issue with this method. The thing is, it works well if you want to work on a page level and that you don't have many pages in your app. But if you have many pages, you are going to paste this code individually into each pages, which is not very practical. What you can do to resolve that is to remove the code from the page and then go into the your app setting, go into SEO slash meta tags and go into the script meta tags in header and paste this code here instead. That way, the code will apply to all your pages and each element that has the same ID attribute than in the code will get its scroll bar removed. This is a much more practical approach and if you have many pages into your app, it is a great way of incorporating this code. And there you go, now you know how to remove scroll bars from Bubble Elements. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe and to like this video, and remember as well, if you want to try out NoCodable Components, click the link in the description, you can have a free trial.